Hello, hello. I have to let this song play for just a few minutes because this is the best song today for what we're talking about. I don't own the rights to this song, but I'm going to let it play for just a few minutes because if you don't know this song, Mo Money, Mo Problems by Puff Daddy, you just don't know. All right, that's enough of that. I can't help it. I love the song so much. Because that is one of the topics of our 10 tips for the dating divorcee. Hello, everybody. It's Dr. Sasheen coming to you live. I'm coming to you live today from the water. I'm basking in the sun. It's been chilly and rainy here. And I was like, I could stay in my house and do this, or I could get out. But the sun's a bit too bright to do it outside. So here I am sitting in the car. Hello. Behind the shades. So we are on day two. I took yesterday off for Labor Day. Hope you all enjoyed your holiday. Day two of the 10 tips for the dating divorcee. If you haven't checked out tip 10 and 9, check out the video. It's on the landing page. Or excuse me, it's on the Facebook page. It's over on Instagram. It's over on Twitter. You can find it. So today we've got number eight and number seven. Number eight is directly related to this song that I am listening to, which is Mo Money, Mo Problems by Mace, Puff Daddy, and the Notorious B.I.G. So, number eight, money matters. No, it really does. Now, a lot of people are going to hear this and go, she's just talking about using people to get what they want, you know, not dating beneath you, blah, blah, blah. That's a whole nother issue. That's for a whole nother therapy session. In terms of post-dating, money matters. And here's why money matters. There's nothing that will derail your dating life faster than relying on people to always have the kind of money that they need to make sure everything is okay on your date. Let me give you a story. Say you have said yes to this amazing person and you all go out and everything seems to be clicking on all cylinders, and then for some reason it's just not. Things aren't going right, the vibe has shifted, something has changed, whatever the case may be, and you find yourself in need of a Lyft, an Uber, or a cab to get home, and you didn't bring any cash. And you didn't bring your credit card, or you don't have enough on your credit card. And so now you're stuck in a restaurant hoping that this person chooses to bring you home if they came to pick you up. Or worse yet, excuse me, you're at dinner, check comes, they thought it was Dutch, they didn't bring enough to cover both of you. Or you're at dinner, check comes, their credit card is declined and they don't have enough cash. Any number of things can happen on a date that requires money. Do not assume that just because you got asked out and someone picked a restaurant and picked you up and put you in a car and drove you someplace that you don't need to think about your own financial health during your date. What if you want something that is a little more expensive on the menu and they can't afford it and they're uncomfortable telling you that they can't afford it, but they kind of shift you in a different direction? Here's the thing. It's 2019. We all need to have a little bit of responsibility for our own financial wherewithal when we're out on a date with someone. There comes a time and a place to say, well, yeah, they should take care of it because they asked me out, or they're the man. Lord, I get tired of hearing that one. Or for whatever the case may be. What really is important here is your own peace of mind, because nothing gives you peace of mind more than knowing you can pay for your own stuff, that you can get yourself that after dinner dessert that you really want, or that you can make sure that you just have a ride home. It is, again, 2019. A lot of women that I talk to, you know, grew up in a time when dating was, the expectation was that someone else was going to pay for you. That's not always the case. A lot of those conversations are not happening before we get out on that date, and all of a sudden we need cash and we don't have it. So you go someplace that doesn't take credit and nobody has any cash on them. Like, trust me, I have been caught in this scenario before when you didn't realize that they didn't take credit and nobody has any cash. So one of the things that I like to stress to women and men who are going out on the dating scene, who might have been out of it for a bit, is it never hurts to keep some cash on you, and it never hurts to have room on your bank card just in case something, just in case. So when I say money matters, no, it really matters. It's because money brings you some peace of mind while you're out and about that doesn't come from anyplace else. Because let's face it, ladies, and this is for the ladies, but also for the men, for the gentlemen, if that date starts going really south, you might need to bolt. And it'd be much easier to bolt if you can call a Lyft or an Uber or a cab because you didn't drive. It's just the way it is. I want you all to be safe out there, and I want you to have fun out there. And honestly, this is one of those areas that nobody likes to talk about, but it's really important. And I bet you thought I was going to say that your date's money, your date is the one who has whose money needs to matter. Do they have enough? No. Do you have enough? Do you have enough to get there, feed yourself, and get home? Those are the three things you'd always ask yourself before you go out on that date. Can I get myself there? Okay, I'm driving myself. Great. Full tank of gas. Fantastic. Can I pay for my own food? Can I buy my own drinks? And can I get myself home? If you can answer those four questions, you are free and clear. You may not need to spend a dime of that money, but you know in your head and you know in your pocketbook and in your wallet that you're okay and that you're safe. Because that funny story about being on a date where it starts to go south and you realize that you might end up having to pay for your own date ended up with me paying for everyone's date because we did not get along. And I ended up picking up the entire tab because he left. We didn't get along that badly. It happens. So I ended up paying for the whole thing. The whole thing. Okay. I wasn't going to stiff the waitress. What am I going to say? I can only pay for half and my only my half and here's half a tip. I would never do that. I've been a waitress. I wouldn't do that to someone. So I took care of it. But I could take care of it because I knew walking in that door that no matter what happened, I know I can take care of mine. And if I have to, I can take care of yours. So always make sure that you have enough money because number eight, money matters. And it really does matter. Number seven, not every date has the potential to be a new mate or a step parent. Woo, this is for the folks with kids. Talking directly to you all because I have one of them. This is for the people who are getting out on the dating scene, and I remember this day so clearly going, well, what is it? So I'm dating and I have a child, and how much of that gets interspersed and what kind of person do I need to be thinking about? Are they here is the reality check. Not every person that you meet needs to be able to fit into step parent mode. Not every person that you meet is going to be a potential mate. Not every person should be looked at through that lens. Here's what this does to you. Number one, it diminishes just being a human being, a fully functioning adult in the world, capable of having a good time without having a label of parent on you. And before someone asks me about the whole, you're always a parent, yes, you are, but you're also always a human being with needs and desires, okay? Number two, it puts a lot of pressure on another person who doesn't actually realize that they're being judged by this weird checklist of things of, will my kid like this or you know, could I see myself living with this for 10 years? Let me tell you something. I have had conversations with people who said things to me after 3 weeks of seeing someone a couple times. Well, I just want to know, you know, I'm just trying to get a sense of if he's somebody I can wake up to for the next 10 years. It's been 3 weeks. Are you kidding me? You have to give yourself and the other person a break. Not every person that you date post-divorce is your mate. They're just a good time. They're just a companion. They're just someone to hang out with. And those people are important. They may not be your forever people, but they will get you through the times when you just want someone to hang out with who reminds you that being a woman is a beautiful thing. You also can't look at everyone as a potential step-parent. Not everybody wants to be a parent, and not every date has to be thinking about, will they get along with my kid? Because if you're doing it right, dating divorcees, and I know that you are because you're out there listening to your 10 tips, your kids aren't even in the picture for a while. They may know they exist. You might flash a picture or two, and we'll get to that later, but your kids haven't even shown up on the radar because you're getting to know a person first. They're not getting to know a family first. They're getting to know a person. And if the main reason that you're dating is to find a new parent for your children or a new mate to step in because you just lost your old one, then first of all, you need to wait on dating. You need to wait. And second of all, you're selling yourself short for all of the things that you could be gaining by just having a good time out in the world and allowing the world to open up before you with all kinds of amazing people who have nothing to do with your kids and nothing to do with marrying you, but are surely a whole lot of fun. All right, that's tip number 8 and 7 today. So as you get out this week, as we post Labor Day here in the United States and doing all the normal things that you do all around the rest of the world, please keep this in mind. Dating is not a contact sport, despite what people may say. And we need to put the fun back into it and allow ourselves to relax. Just because you got a divorce and you're going through some stuff, your highs and lows, your peaks and valleys, doesn't mean that you don't deserve to have a good time and have someone show you a good time and you show them a good time. So thanks for tuning in. Once again, this is Dr. Sashin. As you know, I wrote a book called So You're Getting Divorced. You can pick it up today off of Amazon as either an ebook or in paperback. I'm so excited about it. Please let me know if you do and drop me a note to say what you think of it or leave me a review on Amazon. I greatly appreciate it. Also, share this video. Honestly, there are 60% of marriages end in divorce. And we're all getting remarried multiple times. So it might not be a bad idea to take a moment and go, what are some tips that'll help me navigate the next one so that I have a much more fun time in between marriages than I may have had in my last marriage. All right, everybody, take care and have a great afternoon. Bye now.